Well, hey folks, Species7 here, and welcome back to the channel, and welcome back to Farm Sim 22. You don't even look like you've been used. Hope everybody's doing well today. It is the 3rd of April, a Monday morning, here in a beautiful Sunshine Coast, and we are supposed to have... Ooh, you need some repairage. We are supposed to have ourselves a lovely day today. Which is nice. Sure, $7 will fix that. Which means the tractor... Ooh, $5,600, yeah. I thought it was looking a little beat. Okay, wow. That's a good chunk of gas in there, and we'll be good to go. So... ease our way over to the tank. Nicely done. Okay, shut her off and fill up. We don't have a lot of money. That's because, and as always, a big thank you to my viewers for reminding me. It's been so long since I'd done it this way, I'd kind of forgotten. This here is your precision farm stuff. Here's your pH, there's your nitrogens, there's your yields, seed rates, soil types, all of that. Now, if you don't want to use the little science machine, you can buy, which is what I've done, and I completely forgotten that this option down here was available. You don't have to do the science thing. You can just outright buy the information. So there you are. I bought these three. It's, yeah, about $4,000 a plot. So it's not cheap, but now we have the info. And using my fancy insect antenna machine over there, combined with that info, then we should be in good shape. I think everything else is down there. I don't know. Let's head down and see what's happening today, shall we? Oh, it's actually the same day as yesterday, so. I mean, on the farm, it's still the 2nd of October, right? Okay. But yeah, as I get the money to do so, we will purchase the info on the rest of our fields. And then that will be done. And we should get a better... well, if not a better end result, we'll certainly do better on our day-to-day maintenance of them. I.e. spraying and fertilizing and plowing and lining and, you know, adjusticating the pHs and, you know. Alright, and there is our next piece of kit. Now I think I have a shed over here, don't I? Let's just hop the fence. Yeah, I believe this is a storage shed here, isn't it? Yeah, I've got our water tank, and I've got my little farm tractor down here. Yeah, we can store all of our grass works in there, because, I mean, why not, right? It makes sense. Alright, let's spray that field, and then that will be that. And we can move on to our next mowage, indeed. So... excuse me. Okay. We're not gonna be deploying the sprayer. From inside the cab. Oops. I figured I'd better move that forward because I just remembered at the last second that the first fold and the last fold are backwards. Like, they towards the rear of the tractor, I mean. So, yeah, we kind of needed to... Alright, that looks pretty good. I don't think I'll bother with GPS, it's not that big a field. Let's go. Now, I haven't purchased the information for this field, so I assume it's just sort of putting out whatever the auto config feeds it. Down to the hospital's medical lab here in a couple of hours and get all my blood work done. I don't know, I guess they test my cholesterol levels and stuff after the arterial surgeries to make sure I'm not, well, I guess, putting all their hard work to waste. Alright, we're gonna get a little bit down that edge. Perfect. See, always a great way to pump up your early morning routine. Go down and have the local high-paid vampires suck a little blood on you. Why not? Stop. Thank you. Doing for spray. Pretty good, eh? Pretty good. Yeah, we're definitely gonna have to keep an eye on the finances. I get so excited reading all that stuff on the precision farming there when I finally, found it, but without looking at what monies we actually had, I purchased information on, well, it used to be three fields, now it's our giant cornfield. Unfortunately, of course, I had to purchase, it still shows it as three fields, so I had to pay for information on three different fields. I don't know if it would have worked out cheaper on the one big field or what, but it's done now. Although it certainly did, as I say, cut into what little fundage we had left. No, you don't need to come up, Dexter. Everybody likes you. Everybody says hi. Okay? Now, I know both of those grass fields weren't ready, but I think one of them is. And the other is probably not far behind. And boom. And are you going to do that little bit? Yeah, but you're going to leave it there to look at, aren't you? Cool. All right, good job. This, of course, will not stay down here. Because it has much better things to think about than grass. Although, I guess, we use our baler for crop fields as well. So maybe it should come back home when we're done with it. But, first things first, I believe the John Douglas is waiting for us up here at the top of the hill. So, this is growing. Let's try the upper one first. Yeah, this one's ready. Okie dokie. Ooh, this is gonna be a bit of work, man. Be a bit of work indeed. Okie dokie. Alright, and down you go. Yeah, this is gonna take take a while. So I watched. Oh, good, it is measuring the bigger one. I watched Sooty's little thing on how he does the set A and set B, but. About the A. He just gets it running first and then goes to the set B. Oops. Yeah, Dexter, just enough, okay? Let's turn those rears back on. Okay. Get in and follow our nose. Yeah, see where I missed a line the last time. Grand. Oh, I hate this turning it on and off at the top. Such a pain in the butt. Oh no, it's the one I don't want to lift up. Yeah, it looks like we're gonna have to put a headland in because I don't think that's gonna give me enough otherwise. Yeah, what a pain in the butt. Is that leaving a kind of weird mess to the side? It's supposed to be swathing. Yeah, swath drop. Don't know why it's making such a mess. Hardly saves any freaking time at all when you gotta do all of that. Hardly seems worth it. Although maybe I'm just being too fussy considering it's all grass. Well, this one's working fine. I wonder why that other one's being so sloppy. Don't know that the baler will even pick that up. Map edges look great at a distance, but boy, they're kind of freaky looking up close. See, even with the headland, if I don't shut all of this stuff off and lift it all up, it's just going to make a huge mess. at this side. Seems to be only running in this direction that it, can't get it together enough to make a proper pile. Huh, weird. Oh, well. What can you do? We're just here to mow the lawn. <laughs> 74%. Oh, I wonder if that's the condition of my poor tractor. Or is it the fuel? Ah, that's probably the fuel. It's definitely better than 74% condition. So that's got to be our fuel. Oh, I guess the D stands for diesel. I just noticed it's kind of grayed out, hard to see. And away we go. At least this is a little more level. That's an awkward, awkward angle these mowers go at, eh? Rather excessive. Well, the front one does too, though. Oh, they work. And rather well. Again, such a neat swath when we go this way, eh? Don't know. I don't know. Yeah, it does make for quite the mess, doesn't it? Oh well. Like I said, it's just grass. I think I'll just put up with it. Instead of having to fiddle about so much at the end of each row. Grass, lovely grass. This side, though, is a little different, because I don't want to mess up my field, so I guess what I should do is have run a headland across here as well. Oh well. I didn't. But I am about to. There, now when I turn around, it'll only mess up the, strip between the fields. It won't screw the actual fields up. It's off by quite a bit, isn't it? Weird, considering that we actually started on that edge. Oh, but I didn't start running the GPS till up here, did I? That might be it. Maybe. So yeah, we will, I guess wrap this field. And then again, once we get the bales off her, excuse me, we will and it's gonna be a lot of grass. I wonder what those are. Those little things on the end of those rods? Don't know. They almost look like some kind of sensors, but I don't know what they'd be trying to make sense out of. I'll be honest with you. This guy's been down here for a while, hasn't been washed in a bit. And we are starting to chew through the diesel. That's okay. Down to 71%. This is going to be a process. We got three of these to do. So, yeah, we might at some point in the future be looking to upgrade our mowage a little bit. I mean, the big self-propelled guy doesn't do a bigger swath than this does. So, I don't know. But there is a version you can get that actually tows a unit behind it. So if you wanted to tow a baler or something, you could actually do that. Yeah, a little bit of mess at the end is not a big deal. Not a big deal at all. Just need those couple of headlands in there so the mess doesn't end up in one of our other fields. And then we're good. Look out, crows. There you go. Still not used to the fact that the mirrors don't blink in and out anymore. Where can we see when we're past? There we go. Really good. It's a big field, but we don't have much left. We're gonna get a lot of bales. I can just tell. We'll take the large proportion of them, or the large portion of them, sorry, back to the other farm. And we'll leave a few miscellaneous ones here, of course. But most of the time, we're gonna bring feed down for these other aminals once we actually get them lit up. Didn't quite drop them quick enough that time. Whoops. I think I left about 2 square feet of grass back there unmowed. Oh well, that's actually less than the last time. So, it's an improvement. I'm gonna go with it. But yeah, we are just about done here. Outrageous. And then we've got probably a day's wait before that next one comes. Which is alright, because in the meantime we do have to do baling and wrapping and spraying. So. There we go. What do we got? 2 rows left? That's not bad. This is our 14, 15, so it looks like it takes 16 passes, eh? Hmm. Not bad. Yes, I cut them anyway. There we go. Here for row 15. I think this is the biggest one of the bunch. I've got a few seconds to look at the map, but every time I open it, oh, let's do a save game. Yeah. Oh. Please. I don't know. Last one sucked up. We're done. I said the bottom field might be ready, but I'm not in a panic. I think we can do this one at a time. I might even see about getting a small forage wagon, just so we can haul some of this off to the VGA. And that is all the grass that is the grass. Boom. So lift the front up. There we go. Be-doop. Don't think we need the GPS on it. Oh, what are you doing? Why did that look? Oh, I accidentally dropped the front mower. I was wondering what happened there. I thought for some reason it lowered back to the ground and we were going to start mowing again. I'm like, what's going on? I didn't operate the GPS. I turned it off. That's okay. It's okay. So there we go. That's a big job. But it's done now. So excellent. Excellent. And with that, I'm going to call it an episode. Hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, remember to... So we got a little bit of bailage down here, but... Yeah, we got all those critters. Well, there aren't any yet, but you know what I mean. So, up next, Bailey. Oh boy. Alright guys, take care of each other, hit that like button, and ciao for now.